Today we'll start new data type known as Python sets. These sets are similar to sets that we study in mathematics. In earlier languages like C, C++, Java, we don't have provision to process sets as such that we use in mathematics. But in Python, we are privileged that we can process sets very easily with simple methods and functions. And we declare them in a very simple manner. So they are very easy to use in Python. So first of all, let's see how to create a set. And apart from that, we can perform all the operations on sets like union, intersection, difference, symmetric difference, and other operations that we perform on sets can be performed over here also. And one thing that you need to remember is sets are unordered lists and they are immutable also, like tuples. We cannot change values in sets and they do not contain duplicate values. So there is no duplicacy. First point is there is no duplicacy in sets. Only single value element will be there. And other is they are immutable. And third one is they can contain heterogeneous data elements. And fourth one, which is important, they are unordered. So there are four points that you need to remember about sets. There is no duplicacy in sets. Let's suppose there is a number 10. Two times you have written in set, but it will consider it only one time. They are immutable. That means they cannot be edited. And third one is heterogeneous. They can contain heterogeneous kind of data. And fourth one is unordered. Means if you have given value in this order 10, 20, 30, 40, then it doesn't mean the output will be in this order only. The output can be 20, 10, 40, 30. So they are unordered. So indexing does not you can say that indexing doesn't mean or cannot be applied on sets. So let's see how to create a set. They are very simple to create. You can create them by two methods. First one is write the variable name. Data set 1 is equal to set, and in parentheses we'll give value in braces. Set is a function over here where we are giving values in parentheses, and inside that we are giving the value in braces. So this set has four values, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next, we are going to print it. So it will print. Let's see the output. Let me show you its output first. This is the output. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the values are displaying in the same order in which they are given. But it is not necessary. It will give you the output in the same order because these are unordered sets. Let's see another example. Data set 2. Here we have given the value without using the set method, by directly giving the value in braces. You can see we have given the value in braces, 10, 20, 30, 40. So it will be printed. You can see the output, 40, 10, 20, 30. So you can see they are unordered. So this is output of the second statement. Next is data set 3. If you want to create an empty set, this can be created by data set 3 is equal to empty braces. That means it doesn't contain any element. So while printing it, it will give empty set. Now fourth one is heterogeneous. If I want to provide heterogeneous data elements, they can be given. Data set 4 is equal to, in braces I have given value 1. Then this is a tuple because we are giving value in parentheses. That means it's a tuple. Second element is a tuple. And third element is 5. So we can give heterogeneous data elements in set. And now creating heterogeneous set with list as element. Data set 5, 1, here list is its element, 10, 20, 30 and 5. Print data set 5. And for this, you can see there is an error. See, this is an error. Unhashable type list. What does it mean? It means we cannot create list as a member of a set. Why? Because sets are immutable. Right? I already told you sets are immutable, but lists are mutable. Means they can be edited. So, immutable member cannot be a member of set because sets are immutable. If I put list in list as its member, so it will generate an error, unhashable type list. That means a list cannot be member of a set, but a tuple can be a member, which we have seen in the previous example, 1, 10, 20, 30 and 5, where this is a tuple. A tuple can be a member of a set, but a list cannot be a member of a set. So this thing you need to remember. Next is changing or adding elements to a set. As we have studied that sets are immutable, that means we cannot change value of any element of set. Moreover, they are unordered also. Therefore, indexing has no meaning in context of sets. Therefore, we cannot access elements of a set by specifying by specific indexing or slicing operator. That means if I write 10, 20, 30, 40 and I do indexing of it 0, 1, 2, 3, then it will not perform any operation. Indexing cannot be done of set elements. And another thing, we cannot apply slicing operator over sets because since there are no indexes, so there will be no slicing can be done on the set elements. We can only add a new element in a set and update element in a set. Suppose if I want to add a single element in a set, let's see through an example. Data set 1 with these four values. Print data set 1. First of all, see the output. Since it is unordered, so it is displaying 40, 10, 20, 30. Now I want to add one element to the set. That can be done by using add method. That can be done by using add method. Data set 1.add 35. That means one element is added into it. And you can see the output over here. Then data set 1.update. If I want to add more than one element, then I will use the function method update 5, 18, 27. So when I'm going to print it, it will display all the values, all the elements of the set, but they are unordered. You can see they are unordered. So we can add single element by using add method. And if I want to add multiple elements, that can be done by using update. So I think this is clear to you how to add a new element in the set. Now removing elements from a set. What if I want to add, I want to remove some elements from the set? That can be done by two methods. There are two methods provided. One is called discard and other is called remove. So it can be done by using two methods. Both of them remove a particular element from the set, but there is a little difference between them. I'll tell you by giving an example. First of all, see the example. Removing an element from a set, data set 1 with these elements. First of all, we have printed it as such. Then I want to remove 30 from the set. So I'll write data set 1 dot remove 30. And after that, I'm printing it. And I'll see there will be no 30 in the set. 30 has been removed. Now I have used another method, discard. Data set 1 dot discard 50. Now I'm going to print it again. You can see 50 is not on the set. We are left with 40, 10, 20 and 60. These are the elements. Now I want to discard 35 from the set. Since 35 is not on the list, it will not give you an error. The difference is it will not give any response. Discard method does not give any response if that particular element is not on the set. But if I use remove method and I'm going to remove 35, which is not in the set, it will generate an error that 35 is not in the given set. So you can see through an example, through the output, file remove underscore set dot py, where data set dot remove 35, key error 35. So you can see that discard didn't give any error even when 35 is not found in the set, but remove method generates an error that 35 is not in the list. So whenever we want to remove some element from set, then we should prefer remove method instead of discard. When we are not sure that this element will exist in the set or not, then we should prefer remove. And when we are sure that this element is already in the set, then we can use discard method also. So this is the major difference between discard and remove. You should remember it. Remove generates an error, whereas discard does not generate any error if the element is not in the set. There is another method which is called pop. Pop method. Pop is used to remove any member arbitrarily from the set. We do not need to specify a particular value over here. You'll just write dataset.pop, then it will remove any random member from the set. So I have declared a dataset with these elements, then print dataset, dataset.pop. Now I'm going to print it again to see which element has been popped. So I can see in this list, which one is 40. No, 40 is there, 40, 10, 20, 10 is there, 20, 30, 40. Oh, sorry, I'm seeing this output. This is the output for this. You can see 40 has been popped from the set. This is the output of this function. 40 has been popped from the set. And now, when I want to clear the entire set, then I'll use clear method, dataset.clear. Then I'm going to print it, dataset, then it will return you an empty set with the keyword set and empty parenthesis. That means the set elements have been removed. So you can use pop if you want to remove any arbitrary element from the set, and clear to remove all the elements from the set. So these are two methods that can be used. Now, Python set operations, which are very important and you have used in mathematics also. The very first and the most common operation is set union. Union means to concatenate or combine all the elements of two sets, to perform union among them. So that can be done by using union method. So you can use this operator. The symbol is this pipeline. First of all, you need to create two sets. We have created two sets. X is equal to this and Y is equal to these elements. And union can be performed, print X union Y. Now all the elements will be joined or concatenated by discarding duplicate elements. So you can see 30 is in both the sets. This will occur only once and rest of the elements will be in the set, final set. 50, 20, 40, 10, 60, and 30. Total elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the output. Next, you can also use the union method, print x dot union y, or you can write y dot union x. So both of them have same meaning. Either we write x over here or y over here, and y as argument or x as argument, both of them are having the same meaning and will generate the same output as that of this output. So the output will be same. By using any of these three methods, you can perform union of two sets x and y. It's very simple. Next is set intersection. So intersection means only common members will be displayed, which are common in both the sets will be displayed. So you can see x is equal to 10, 20, 30, y with these elements. So the common element is 20 and 30 in these sets. So only 20, 30 will be in the output. And for intersection, we use this operator, ampersand, or you can say, this is not address of, this is ampersand operator. So x ampersand y, this is used for intersection. It will give the output 20, 30. Similarly, you can use the method intersection, x dot intersection y, or you can use y dot intersection x, and the output will be the same. 20, 30, 20, 30. You can use them in either order, y dot intersection x or x dot intersection y, and output will be the same. It will give you common elements among two sets. Next is set difference. Difference is just like subtraction. If I write x minus y, that means all the elements from x, all the y elements from the x will be subtracted. Let's see through an example, then you'll understand it better. We have these two sets, 10, 20, 30, x set, y set is 30, 40. That means from 10, 20, 30, 30 will be removed, which is y's element. 30 will be removed and I'll get the output 10, 20. X minus y, print x minus y will generate the result 10, 20. And I can also use this method, x dot difference y, which is having same meaning and results in 10 and 20. And if I want to subtract y minus x, if I want to perform operation in reverse order, that is y minus x, that means all the elements which are not, which are in x also will be removed from y. So 30 is there in x. So 30 will be removed from y. So I'm left with only 40. Y minus x will result in 40. Similarly, y dot difference x will result in 40 also. So you can, this concept will be clear to you. It's very simple. X minus y, x dot difference y, y minus x, or y dot difference x. So these operations can be performed as per the requirement. Next is set symmetric difference. For this, caret symbol is used and it gives the error, it gives the output for of the elements which are not common in both the sets, which are not common in both the sets. They are removed and rest of the elements are results into output. So let me show you with programming illustration. X is equal to 10, 20, 30 and y is 30, 40. So you can see that 30 is common in these both sets. And when I write x, then set symmetric difference, this is cap symbol, y, the answer will be 10, 20, 40. That means it is opposite to intersection. Intersection results in common elements, whereas set symmetric difference results in uncommon elements. The elements which are uncommon will result in output. This can also be written by using method x dot symmetric difference y. So the output will be the same. So let me show you the output. 40, 10, 20, 40, 10, 20. 30 was common in both the sets. So 30 is removed and we are left with only 40, 10, 20, 40, 10, 20. And it doesn't matter in which order we are writing it. When we write y caret x or y dot set symmetric x, the answer will be again 40, 10, 20. Because they are unordered, you can see in any order output 20, 10, 40 or whatever. But output of all these four statements is same. This is called set symmetric difference. It is important. The uncommon elements will be displayed in the output. These three elements and 30 will be removed. This is called set symmetric difference. Now there are various methods of sets. Some of them we have already studied. Add, which is used to add one element. Update is used to add more than one element. Discard is used to remove an element. Remove is also used for the same purpose, but it generates error if element is not present in the set. pop removes any arbitrary element from the set. Clear, it removes all the elements. Copy will generate a copy of the set. Union, intersection, difference, set symmetric difference. These all of them we have studied just now. Next is difference update. Intersection update removes all elements of another set from this set. It is also same, that means it results in the same set. If I write difference update x comma y, that means the result will be in x, the final result will be in x. Update means it results in the set which is written at first place. Similarly, intersection update, it performs the intersection between x and y and the results will be assigned in x. So these are used for assigning output to the first set. Similarly, symmetric difference update, this is also used. It will perform symmetric difference between two sets and the result will be assigned to the first set which is given in the argument. Is a subset, this is used to check whether this element is a part of this set and returns in either true or false. Is a superset, this is also used to check whether this element is a superset of a particular set, it returns result in either true or false. Is a disjoint, returns true if two sets have null intersection. That means if there is no common elements in sets, then it returns in true. Otherwise, it returns in false. So it checks whether sets are disjoint or joint. So if there is no common element, that means they are disjoint and it results in true value. So these are various methods of sets. In operator, we have already studied this operator so many times. This is used to check whether a particular element present in a list or tuple or set or not. This can be checked by using just writing in 10 in X. So 10 is present in this X set, it will return true. 50 in Y, 50 is not in Y set, it returns false. So it is very simple. We have already studied it so many times in operator. Next, we can also access sets by using for loop, similar to lists and tuples. So we can do this, gx is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and cities with these values. Now for n in gx, print n. So it will print all the set elements one by one by augmenting gradually, automatically. For n in gx, print n, since they are unordered, so it is printing 40 at first place, 40, 50, 10, 20, 30. So it will print the result in unordered manner. I'm going to print for city in cities. It will print these cities. Let's see in which order it is displaying. Goa, Mumbai and Delhi. However, we have given the values in the order Delhi, Mumbai, Goa. But as it is unordered, it is displaying the result in different order. And for C in set Kolkata. That means we have given a string over here and we are going to access its characters one by one. So it will print in unordered way. You can see the output. It is not in Kolkata. It is A-T-L-O-K-K. So it can be in any order, but you can access set elements in sets element using for loop also. Next is functions. There are various functions associated with sets, which are all, any. All means if all the elements of a set are true, if any of the element of set is true, it returns the length of the set, whether 5 elements, 4 elements, maximum, the largest element from the set, the smallest element from the set, it sorts the set elements, it performs addition of all the elements of the set and enumerate, it separates all the elements of the set. So these are the methods or functions which can be used with the sets. Next, there is another form of set which is known as frozen set. Python language offers a new data type of sets called as frozen set. It is clear from the name frozen, that means we cannot edit members of the set. although we cannot edit members of a simple set also, but the difference is that the functions or methods like add, remove, discard are not applicable on frozen sets, which are applicable on simple sets, but they are more, you can say, read-only sets, as add, remove, and discard methods are not applicable on these frozen sets. So let's see through an example. We have set Y set with value 40, 50, 60, and we are going to add a new element 12, print Y set. So let's see what happens. The output is 40, 50, 60, 12, because this is a simple set that we have created. It's a simple set. Now, 12 is added to the set, as we have seen in the output. But when we create a frozen set, X set is equal to frozen set with values 10, 20, 30, and we are going to add a new element 12, and then we are going to print it. It will generate an error. Frozen set object has no attribute add, because we cannot add an element to a frozen set. But for a simple set, it can be added. But for a frozen set, a new element cannot be added to the set. So this is all about frozen sets. I hope this concept is clear to you all. This is all about sets in Python.